in terms of gold medals won by a female athlete. This is what she has done in just her fourth SEA Games. It's her 13th goal to go along with 5 silvers and 2 bronzes. And in front of her, she only has Tao Li, Nurul Huda Abdullah, Junie Sung, Patricia Chan, and Jocelyn Yeo. But remember, those ladies took almost 10 SEA Games, except for Patricia, of course, who retired early. The ladies took at least 6 to 7 SEA Games to receive their gold medals. She's only done it in her fourth SEA Games, with still more gold medals to come. This lady is a real phenom. No two ways about it. Swimming Federation. The double in the backstroke, 100 and 200 now. Roxanne Yu once again has to settle for bronze, just as she did in 2015.
Bronze medalist, Philippines. Represented by Roxanne Ashley Yu with a time of 2:19.98.
Her personal best time this year, but not her personal best, which was clocked at the Youth Olympic Games a couple of years ago in Nanjing. Saputra's third silver medal in a row. After winning in 2011, she must be so sick of the sight of Nguyen Tian Vien. All three times, she's had to play bridesmaid to the one and only queen.
And ladies and gentlemen, gold medalist and SEA Games champion with a new game record time of 2:13.64, represented by Thi An Bien Nguyen from Vietnam.
The first swimmer to go below 2:14 at the SEA Games, Nguyen Tian Vien, also becomes only the second swimmer after Chonlathom Borathomrong to win this event 3 times in a row. In fact, just the third after Chonlathom and Nanik Sowanji. And looking at her career, by the time the next SEA Games come, she will be the first to win this 4 in a row. Another goal for Nguyen Tian Vien at the SEA Games. And there's no doubt, of course, there is the undisputed at the SEA Games from Vietnam. The Viet vessel has conquered all almost all and almost every event already at these games. 9 events that she's won gold medals in. And this event as well, she won bronze at the last Asian Games. And surely now that will be the next territory for her to stamp on.
I think so. Very impressive to get a bronze medal at the Asian Games for someone as young as she is. So I think she's got a good opportunity there. You know, she trains, you mentioned earlier, she trains in the US, she trains back in Vietnam, she's got 2 coaches. So I think she's, with the strong support team that she has, you know, we could still see her improve heaps and bounds over the coming years, I think.
And you were looking at the race earlier on, I mean, from a very objective coach's point of view, what do you think she needs to work on in order to catch up with the likes of the Japanese and the Chinese, who are probably the best in the world in terms of the backstroke events, who will be there at the Asian Games too?
I think it's probably the underwater, even though she looked really good in underwater here compared to the rivals.